Hi, my name is Courtney Workington, and I voice Elise Davenport in Project Infinity. This has been such a fun project to be a part of, so let's jump right into the questions. So, like I said, my name is Courtney. I live in Alberta, Canada, and besides voice acting, I'm a singer, dancer, and traditional stage actress. I got my start with the arts at a really young age doing musical theater, and ever since then, I've had a huge passion for anything theatrical or artistic. Honestly, voice acting always seemed like a natural fit for me. When I was a kid, I constantly tried to do impressions of my favorite cartoon characters, whether it was Blue's Clues or Scooby-Doo or the Powerpuff Girls. I was always trying to see if I could figure it out. Eventually, I realized that there were real people making careers out of the voices behind these characters. So I set my sights on becoming one of them. My family was super supportive and they helped me find the right people to get the proper training in this field. That, along with my stage acting, it felt like a really good combination, and eventually I started getting small little jobs for commercials and then, you know, bigger stage productions, but I've always set my sights on voice acting. That is my number one passion and I would die to be in something huge. Elise is very different from a lot of the characters I normally get cast in. For the most part, the kinds of characters I voice are nasally, loud, brash, overdramatic, and Elise seems to kind of be the opposite of that. She's the grounded one of the group. She, you know, isn't afraid to speak up for what she believes in, but she still cares about everyone deeply. So I decided to give her a more full, calm, and soothing sounding voice, which is a little bit different from my natural voice. So I need to get in the right headspace for her when I'm voicing her. I love it though. It is definitely a challenge to voice her because I'm not used to voicing a character like this. But at the same time, that's part of what I love so much about her is that I get the chance to show that I can do different voices, you know? I can do my loud, screechy characters, but I can also bring things back down to earth and be that calming force. And I just love Elise so much. I love that she can stick up for herself and isn't afraid to speak up. And she's just such a good character. There's so much good to come in this series. When I know I'm gonna be recording for Elise, I try my best not to scream, not to be loud, not to hurt my voice in any way. Which can be difficult because I am a fairly loud person. So I make sure I plan ahead, I'm gonna drink some tea, I'm gonna have some honey in it, and I'm gonna make sure my voice is as soothed as possible. I also really need to make sure that my nose isn't plugged in any way, shape, or form, so I try to breathe through my nose and I try to make everything as soft and whole sounding as possible, if that makes any sense. Other than that, I kind of have to get in the right headspace for her. I add this little like lilt to her voice where if I were to say Morris, I'd go, Morris. And if you hear that little like small dip in my voice, I try to give her that to give her like this angelic musical sounding aspect to her voice because she is a happy and sweet person. It doesn't normally take me too long to record for her. I usually do several takes of one line just in case one of them isn't what they're looking for, or a couple of them. It just depends on the script. Elise isn't the main character. So sometimes I'm in it a lot and other times I'm not in it too much. So sometimes it can just be me sitting down for half an hour and just getting the lines out after reading the script. Or it can be an hour and a bit. It really just depends, and it also depends on how long the lines are. Because if I'm gonna be doing a long monologue, I want it to have the right impact. I don't just want to be spitting out the lines in a monotone voice. I want to do my character justice. I want to elicit the right feelings for our wonderful audience, so it depends on that, really. I would love to say that I'm a lot like Elise, but I don't really know if that's the case. I am willing to speak up for what I believe in just like she is, but at the same time, Elise is a lot more calm and level-headed and willing to hear everybody out. I guess she's the kind of person I strive to be more like. It makes voicing her pretty interesting, and she's a very necessary part of the team in my opinion. I touched on this a little bit earlier, but when getting into character for Elise, I find myself trying to think calming and soothing thoughts, and I read the script over from beginning to end just to kind of get in her headspace, you know, think the way that she would think and how she would react to every situation so I can appropriately voice her. Other than that, I just think calming, soothing, not judging happy thoughts. She's an interesting character, that's for sure. Okay, I love Elise so much. But if I had to pick another character to voice in the show, I would pick Princess Annabelle. And she sounds like an interesting choice for me, but the reason is because originally I auditioned for Princess Annabelle. I didn't audition for Elise at all, actually. I think it would be interesting to see how that would turn out, you know, in another universe if I got her. How would that have gone over? For that reason, definitely, but there are so many good characters in the show that I would be happy voicing anyone, to be completely honest. My experience working on Project Infinity has been absolutely amazing. In case you guys haven't noticed, we have a super talented cast, but not only that, we're all really supportive of each other. Even if we have some other projects going on, we kind of talk to each other about it or share, you know, what we're working on. And everyone is so supportive and kind and sweet, and it's just so nice to be in a positive community like this. The cast is amazing, our directors are amazing, and whenever I received a new script, it is professional, my lines are highlighted for me, but I can see the entire script so I know the context of all of my lines. I've worked for projects in the past that have not at all been like this, and just working on something so professional has been amazing and so much less painless. All I want to say to the fans is thank you guys so much for your support. Every time we upload a new episode, I read the comments and everybody is just so kind. It really is nice to know that all our hard work is paying off and people are actually enjoying it. So thank you guys. It's so appreciated and mind-blowing. There's a lot of really awesome stuff to come. Of course, we've recorded a couple episodes in advance, so I do have an idea of where this is going. And I think all of you guys are really gonna love it. So stay tuned for some awesome content. And if you want to follow me on any social media, I'm on Twitter and Instagram, both at Court Workington. So feel free to check me out there and keep watching.